The high-wealed area of outstanding natural beauty is a stronghold for remaining species-rich, otherwise known as unimproved, grassland in the UK. Due to changing agricultural, social and economic demands on the countryside, many areas of grassland have now lost their variety of wildflower and grassland species. These grasslands have become semi-improved or been degraded even further to become species-poor improved grasslands. Fragments of unimproved grassland still remain in areas on the edge of traditional farm holdings, on slopes or low-lying ground and in field corners. This short clip will give an introduction to identifying these three types of grassland: unimproved, semi-improved and improved. Lowland unimproved semi-natural grasslands, as they're broadly termed, are mostly the result of human activity. They have developed through forest clearance and wetland drainage, probably since Mesolithic times, in order to provide fodder for domestic livestock. Grazing, cutting, and to a lesser extent, burning, have been important factors in both the creation and the maintenance of these grasslands. Plant species now occurring in these grasslands are likely to have originated from the woodland ground flora, from open habitats such as cliffs and sand dunes, and grazing by native mammals. Unimproved neutral grassland. This type includes all semi-improved grasslands which have had some damaging operations altering the species, and unimproved grassland, occurring on mainly neutral soils. It includes enclosed and managed grassland such as hay meadows and pastures, a range of damp and tall grasslands. Lowland meadows are recognised in the High Weald AONB as land managed mainly as traditional hay meadows or pastures. This management is crucial during the flowering season when these grasslands are colourful because they contain a high proportion of broad-leaved herbaceous species relative to grasses. Some characteristic species such as green winged orchid and adder's tongue fern are now scarce. The High Weald AONB also includes acid grassland. This type includes both semi-improved and unimproved grassland occurring on acid soils, derived from rocks such as sandstone, and on superficial deposits such as sands and gravel. Although the habitat is typically species poor, a wide range of varieties of types of grassland occurs. Both neutral and acidic semi-natural grasslands are key, not only for their plant numbers and variety of species, but also for the diversity of birds, invertebrates and lower plants that they also support. Most types of neutral and acidic lowland grassland, in the absence of management by cutting, grazing or occasional burning, would undergo vegetation change, resulting in reduced species diversity and a shift from one grassland type to another. Left unchecked, this would eventually lead to succession, where the grassland would be overtaken by bramble, weeds, scrub and young trees, and finally in many years become a woodland area again. Semi-improved is grassland which may have been ploughed in the past and had some artificial fertiliser or sprays applied. These have a significantly reduced species diversity, yet still retain a number of native grasses and wildflowers, and can therefore still be of high conservation value. Remember, one operation to species-rich grassland can cause irretrievable damage. Semi-improved grasslands often contain a couple of dominant wildflowers such as common birdsfoot trefoil and common sorrel. They are crucial linking habitats and can often be useful areas for enhancement to increase the numbers of wildflowers or as foraging areas for a range of species. Improved grasslands. This type includes species-poor rye grassland, occurring on all soil types that have been either sown or created by modification of unimproved grassland by fertilisers and selective herbicides for agricultural or recreational purposes. It includes grassland that has been reseeded for more than 1 year. Almost all areas are grazed and some are cut for hay or silage. Improved grasslands are particularly characterised by the abundance of ryegrass species and white clover. Sometimes such grasslands are temporary and sown as part of the rotation of arable crops. Where not managed as pasture, improved grasslands are often mown regularly, either for silage production or in non-agricultural context for recreational and amenity purposes. Potential habitat of even moderately species-rich grassland can be represented on road or driveway verges, in gardens or in forgotten areas around houses, farms and industrial units. It's important that we update the area and value of this type of grassland in the High Weald. Therefore, if you own or suspect you own semi-improved or unimproved grassland, we would like to hear from you. Please contact the WMI to register your site and for support.